It's festival season, Jazz Fest, French Quarter Fest, and Ferret Street Fest, but tonight we're taking you to some celebrations you might be missing out on. First, it's NOLA Pyrate Week, and then we hop over to the Rose for a festival about camping, food, and music. Plus, the restaurant menu that's offering your favorite festival foods will have the chef in. The 504 starts right now.
It's the 504 on My54. Now, here's Sheba Turk.
Good evening and welcome to the 504. Well, the 6th annual NOLA Pyrate Week is underway right now. The name might have you a little bit confused, but really it's all about giving back and a lot of fun events going on. So here to talk more with us about that is Captain John Swallow and Quartermaster Seika Hellbound. But first, you guys have to explain what a pirate is, because let's break it down for people. You guys are not in character. You're real pirates.
We're as close as you're probably going to find.
What does that mean?
Well, it's kind of following the pirate lifestyle, if you will. Uh-huh. The giving back, take what you can, give something back, has been our motto for all 6 years of NOLA Pyrate Week.
So a good motto to have.
It's originally something that was used aboard ship, mm-hmm. to when they were lashing the ship to the dock. So you'd be throwing out a rope and take what you can, give something back so that it's tight and the ship is tight against the pier. Mm-hmm. But we're using it obviously in the context of taking what you can of the culture and the fun that is New Orleans and give something back, giving back to the community, giving back to various community groups and doing some good work around the city and around Louisiana, in fact.
And Seika, you were telling me this kind of got started after Hurricane Katrina.
It did, yeah. We came down right after Katrina to help out, mm-hmm. and so we thought, you know, about a year or so later, what could we do to actually make a difference here and get a lot of people into the city? And there's mm-hmm. a lot of pirate brethren spread out across Canada, the United States, the UK, all around the world.
There's a lot of pirates.
There is a lot. There's a lot of groups.
Wow.
And sort of they're active, and there's a lot of sort of reenactment that goes on. And of course, the movies have sort of helped catapult that as well.
Mm-hmm.
But we put together an event that essentially we started working with small grassroots organizations like Lower9.org, mm-hmm. and we went out and we started building, helping them build houses. So you had pirates out helping, you know, do the rebuild in the Lower Nine, and then when the BP spill happened, we started down in the bayou with cleaning up and helping out groups like Keep Terrebonne Beautiful, mm-hmm. and Bitnap and all the different ones that we could. So it's just a continuation. I mean, we like to come to New Orleans. We like people to come into town and, mm-hmm. and experience the culture and have fun. And it's not always about, you know, doing the pirate thing, but it's, you know, you dress up, you get out there, you go eat, you go listen to some music, you kind of enjoy. We have events that we do, and, you know, we try and get everybody a little bit involved. And even coming into the city now and spending your money still helps the economy.
It is. Y'all are doing some great work. And you're dressed in these costumes while you're doing the great work.
Always.
These outfits, I love them. Now, can anybody be a pirate? Could I be a pirate now?
Absolutely.
Wow.
Absolutely.
And you told me that people, little kids on the street will stop you and say, that's a pirate, even when you don't have this outfit on.
Yeah,
what's that like?
I could probably be in my pajamas, and some four-year-old would stop his parents and go, look, mommy, a pirate.
That is unbelievable. Okay, so talk a little bit more about this week. I know some of the events have already happened. Talk about what's happened so far, and then we can go.
Right. We had Friday night, we had our annual sort of get-together at Pirates Alley Cafe. They've been a great, great folks there, and they've always supported us. So we had our sort of little, you know, drinking night, party night there.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday, we did a little wander around. We did a cemetery tour for folks who hadn't had that opportunity to go and check out some of the really cool cemeteries that are here in New Orleans. And then Sunday, we had a pirate wedding in the alley, which was great fun.
A pirate wedding.
We had a couple that came all the way from Long Island, New York, and we married them up in the alley, and they tied the knot literally and figuratively. And
married them up in the alley. I love it. You guys have fun, and
yeah.
you're doing some great work out there. Okay, so I know a lot of people are still thinking you're Johnny Depp from Pirates of the Caribbean. So the first thing you guys said when you came on, you wanted to dispel some of those myths. So let's talk
Absolutely.
About some of the things people think about pirates. First off, walking the plank. We see that in every pirate movie.
Well, that's where it came from, pirate movies. Somebody thought it was a good idea. It was sort of a Peter Pan-ish thing. First of all, it's a terrible use of lumber.
It's
something
not real.
That could be patching a hole in the ship.
You has nothing to do with pirates.
Don't waste it like that. Pirate punishments were, frankly, a lot more terse than walking off the end of a plank. That's too much like a diving board into the sea.
Okay.
It's like giving you a chance. Not to mention, if you walk off the plank, you're gone.
All right.
They generally would punish crew keep them aboard if at all possible. So punish them enough that they were really, really sorry and weren't going to do it again.
All right, and we are almost out of time, but I do want to get to, you are a female pirate. We never or hardly ever see that in movies.
No, and I mean, and then when they are portrayed, it, you know.
They have on tight clothes and or
they do, and it's not real. I mean, there were women definitely aboard ship. There were women pirates. Some of the most famous pirates that we don't hear about was someone like Madam Cheng, who they touched on in Pirates of the Caribbean. Mm-hmm. But she had a massive fleet. Her husband passed away. She took over the reins. They had, you know, over 200,000 pirates under her commission.
All right, so you're here to show us.
Yeah, yeah.
Female pirates.
That's it.
All right, well, thank you guys so much for being here. Well, NOLA Pirate Week runs through Monday, and this Saturday is going to be the second annual Pirate Day in Houma. That'll be from 10 a.m. until 5 p.m., and for more information, you can log on to NOLAPirateWeek.com, and that is pirate with a Y. You can also call 504-708-2313. All right, well, we've got the pirates down, but we keep the festival talk going tonight. Later on in the show, we're in the kitchen with a preview of the Spring Festival menu at Tivoli and Lee. But first, we head over to the Tivoli Blues Festival going down in La Rose this weekend. The Collin Lake Band gets us in the mood with some good music.